So on your mat today, if you have blocks, have a strap, that's great. If you don't, that's okay. Someone actually told me that they used cans of corn as blocks. So people are very creative. So, you know, just be here with what you have. And this is a flow practice, but always listen to your body. Be true to who you are. And have fun mostly. See if you can practice gratitude today. You know, it's complicated times, but really how privileged we are that so many of us during a global pandemic can be in our home and be safe in our home, and we can stay warm and cool enough. We can read, we can work, we can still be educated, we can be creative. I'm sure some of you are doing very creative things at home. I've seen some of your videos, and they're amazing. And some of you are getting incredibly funny videos. And talking with loved ones, whether they be in the house with us or not in the house with us, thanks to Zoom technology. And thank God for those of us able to practice. And if you're here now, then you're good and you're safe. And you hopefully have a fridge stocked with what you need and you have what you need. I mentioned this on Tuesday in my class that I had been thinking that if someone had mentioned to me a few months ago, you know, I just want to let you know that in a few months from now, you will be restricted to your home with just essential outings, shopping, and now being required to wear a mask and gloves, not going more than 100 meters. Stores will be closed. Cafes will be closed. Shops will be closed. I think my reaction would have been, I'm not capable. I can't do it. But we can. I can. We adjust. We have this ability to adjust. So for the next 75 minutes, what we do on our mat is less important than what we do in life. So adjust yourself on your mat, but know that you are being given the tools to adjust in life, and we are also capable. So exceed yourself by exceeding yourself and have gratitude on the mat. So come to a comfortable seat. If you can, have your right leg in front of your left. Sit tall, root down with the sitting bones. Jordan, if you could start the music, that would be great. And just come into your breath. I don't hear music. I don't know if you guys hear music. Jordan? Their music?
Yeah, no, you don't hear it?
No. But meanwhile, come into your breath. Relax your shoulders. Still don't
I've
hear the
set
music.
No. Set in some
Can you start it at the beginning of the song? Okay. Relax your jaw. Relax your eyebrows. Scan the body. Just relax anywhere that feels like it needs a little relaxing
and
tight. Become conscious of your breath. I say this all the time. It's your most powerful tool. And we forget that sometimes. But it's good to remember it. So deep breaths in through the nose and out through the mouth. Again, welcome everybody who has just joined.
Water once.
A few more breaths here.
Never.
And again, I said before, we're going to flow, but take it at your own pace. Take your hands out to the side and inhale, reach the arms up. Begin to make movements. Right arm stretches, left arm stretches. Waking up the side body.
I swam on the devil's lake, but never.
Bring your hands up. Release your shoulder
heads.
Interlace your fingers. Maybe turn your palms to face up. Look up. feel long. Release the hands and begin to come forward. Doesn't matter how far forward you come, but you want to lengthen the spine. If your hands come to the mat, just crawl them out in front of you.
You're broken down
and keep in with the breath.
Living life on the merry-go-round.
Begin to walk your hands in, rounding the back for this one. Coming back up.
I see it in you, so we can walk it out.
Hands to the side. Take your right fingertips down to the right. Walk them out. Maybe bend the right elbow. Take the left arm up and stretch it over the left ear, keeping your left sitting bone on the ground. It can be here or here or here. Think about rising up. Coming back up. Take your right fingertips behind you. Left hand comes to the outside of the right knee. A lengthening in breath and a gentle twist to the right. It's early in the practice, early in the morning. Respect your body, have compassion for the body and gratitude. Coming back to center, interlace your fingers behind your back. Keep the elbows bent and your hands off your butt and back. And open up the shoulders and the chest. Stay here if this feels enough. If you want, you can come forward again, lifting the hands.
And it feels like it's getting hard to breathe. And I know you feel like dying.
Don't let it get hard to breathe. Keep breathing. Inhale, come up. And release the hands. Keep your left foot in. Take your right leg out. For those of you who haven't turned on your video, I invite you to, so I can take a look at you guys and just know that we are all practicing together. Right leg out to the right, hands on either side of the right foot. It's a modified Janu Shirshasana. Inhale, lengthen and fold forward. If you have a strap, you can do it, or a towel or a t-shirt. I think we all keep saying this. You can improvise with anything. And you can hold on. Again, it's not how far down you come. It's the intention and the lengthening your spine and feeling good in the body. And slowly inhale up, not how far down you come. It's the intention and the lengthening your spine and feeling good. I'm echoing and I'm delayed. Lift the hips and rise. That's better. And slowly lower the hips down. Hug your right knee in and hold on to the right foot. You can stay here. You can bring it to 90 degrees, or you can begin to stretch the right leg up towards your head. Keep the sitting bones rooted. Don't fall onto the tailbone. Bend the knee and switch the legs. Left shin in front of the right. Inhale, reach up. Interlace your fingers, turn the palms up. Release the shoulder heads down. Take a lengthening inhale. Release the hands as you come forward slowly. Maybe fingertips reach the ground, maybe not. Let your head drop. Inhale, this time try to come up with a flat, lengthened back, pulling your belly in towards your spine and up towards your ribs. Take the arms out to the side, left fingertips walk their way out to the left. Take the right arm up, bend the left elbow maybe, and reach the right arm over the right ear. Side bend. Warming up the body. Come back up. Left fingertips come behind you. Right hand on the outside of the left knee. Lengthening inhale. Gentle twist to the left. Turn the body to the left. Bend the right elbow. Breathing. Come back to center. Interlace your fingers behind your back. Bend the elbows. Take your hands off your back. Stretch, opening up the chest and shoulders, and maybe straighten the elbows. That feels good. If folding forward feels good, go for it. I'm going to stay up this time. Nice. Release your hands. Take your left foot out to the left. Right foot stays in like in a tree. Modified Janu Sirsasana. Take your hands to the sides of your left foot. You can use the strap if you want. This time I'm not going to use the strap. Inhale, lengthen. Fold forward. You can hold on to your shins or cross your hands and begin to fold forward. Breathing, let your head drop. Nice guys. Inhale, reach up. You can stay, or if it's okay for your knee, reach your right hand behind you, push the hips up, left arm lifts. A little bit of a back bend here. Lower down the hips, bring the left foot in, hug the knee. Can hold on to the bottom of the foot, left foot, and either bring it to 90 degrees, hold here, or begin to straighten the leg. Keeping the back straight and maybe bending the elbows. You see where your flexibility and your body takes you. Breathe. And slowly bend the knee. And bring the knees together. Come onto your hands and knees. All fours. Tabletop position. Separate your fingers, middle finger or index finger pointing towards the front of the mat. Hips over knees. Toes can be curled under or not. And start with body rolls, warming up the wrists, the knees, a little bit of the shoulders also. Just getting into the fluids in the joints. And then switch directions. And then come to a tabletop, flat back. Turn your hands upside down where your palms are facing you and the fingers are facing each other. So we're doing something for the wrist here. Bend the elbows, come down. Inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, and come up. Turn your hands regular, inhale to cow pose. Sometimes I like to hold the first one, opening the chest, dropping the belly, looking forward. And slowly transition, pressing down into cat pose. Press, press, press around the back. And one breath, one movement. Inhale to cow. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cow. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Come to a neutral spine. Bring your right knee into your chest. Hold here, around the back like cat. Step the right foot between your hands. Slide your left knee back. Pat it if you need it. Straighten the right leg. Half splitter running, runner's pose. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Stay here or bring the right foot down. Fingers up, curl the back toes, lift the back knee. Back heel up. Similar pose, similar but different. Straighten the right leg and bend both knees. Inhale, we are here. we're here for all of us. And straighten. And lower. I love this song, guys. Those of you who practice regularly with me know that certain songs really speak to me. And then step the right knee back to meet the left. Your knees are already behind your hips. Walk your hands forward for Anahatasana, puppy pose, reaching the hands forward, getting a shoulder stretch, dropping your forehead. You can also drop your chin. You might not like the neck extension there, but either one's okay. Keep breathing. And walk your hands in. Align your knees under your hips. Take one cow. Exhale, cat. Come to a neutral spine. Bring the knee into the chest. Hold. A little bit of core here. And step the left foot between the hands. Slide the right knee back. Pat it as needed. Straighten the left leg. Half Hanumanasana, runner's lunge. Hands can be back here. Hands can be here. You just want a long spine and you want to be comfortable. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Lengthen. Bring the left foot back down. Curl your back toes under. Lift the back knee. And straighten both legs. And then bend. And straighten. And bend. Inhale, lengthen both legs. And bend. Bring the left knee beside the right. One more time, puppy pose. Reach forward. This time, if you want, you could bring your palms together. Bend the elbows, bring the thumbs to the nape of the neck. And isometrically, without moving, you're pulling your elbows and arms towards the body. And slowly release. Plant your hands down, push yourself up. Fingers spread, claw the mat. Move up a little bit, spread the fingers. And from here, step back into a plank pose. Come into your first downward dog. Breathe. Knees can be bent. Get your hips way up high. Have a long spine. Pull the belly in and up. Pedal the feet. And then come to a still downward dog. Knees can always be down. Then we're going to roll with a round cat back to high plank. And bend the knees and come back into downward dog. Again, two more of those. Roll with the cat back. Bend the knees. Push back. Roll forward. Bend the knees. Push back. Downward dog. Breathe. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out through the mouth. Inhale your feet together. Take an exhale. Inhale the right leg up. Waking up the hips. Bend the knee. Open up right hip over left. Extend the leg straight. Turn the hip down. Bring the right knee next, right foot next to the left. Inhale the left leg up. Way up high. Bend the knee. Open up left hip over right. Extend the leg straight. Turn the hip down. Bring the left foot next to the right. Bend the knees. Walk up a third of the way. You determine what a third of the way is.
right hand comes to the center of your mat. Take your left hand and reach for the right ankle or right shin. You can bend one of your knees if you need to, the left one. It's what I would recommend if you're going to bend a knee and twist. Did you all hear that? I won't wear makeup on Thursday. So for the ladies out there, is anyone wearing makeup anymore? I'm just curious. I'm just putting it out there. You can leave a chat. Let me know. I'm taking a poll if anyone's putting makeup on. None of you need it. You're all beautiful. And then switch. Left hand comes to the center. Straight legs. You can take your right hand to the outside of the left shin. You can bend the right knee and twist or keep both knees straight. Who we are is enough. And release that. Toe heel your feet in. Come to the top of your mat. And I'm going to turn to face you. And come into a flat back. Oh, here, this is a better view. Exhale, fold. Knees bent. Ragdoll pose. Grab onto your elbows in front of you or behind you. Rock forward and back. So you play around with balance here. You're all beautiful. Release the hands. Toe heel your feet closer together, but they do not need to be touching. Round the back and roll up one vertebra at a time. Coming to standing pose. Palms face out. Inhale, reach up. Mountain pose. Urdhva Hastasana. You can bend the elbows. If you want, take it into a back bend. Inhale, reach up. Grab onto your left wrist with your right hand. Inhale. Exhale, side bend to your right. For those of you who want, you can lift the left foot. Take it behind the right. And bring the left foot back and gaze up. Switch. Left hand grabs onto the right wrist. Lengthen. Exhale, side bend to your left. If you want, take your right foot behind the left. Release the foot. Come back. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold forward. Remember, knees could be bent. Inhale, reach up with intention. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Bend the knees. Plant the hands. Step back to a high plank. Can always drop one knee or both knees for high plank. Absolutely. Rock forward and back. And then shoulders over wrists. For the first one or for anyone that follows, the Chaturanga could be drop your knees, hug the elbows in, drop the belly. Good. Coming into a Sphinx pose, sliding your forearms forward, opening up your chest, again, isometrically. Pulling your hands, arms towards you, opening the chest. Feet are wider apart. Curl the toes under. Lift your knees. Lift the belly. Forearm plank, getting right into it. Hold for three. Two, one, drop the knees, drop the belly, untuck the toes, thumbs at your midribs, inhale to cobra, elbows bent, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, and curl the toes, push back into downward facing dog. Breathing here.
feel grounded, feel present. You are here. Any other thoughts that are getting in the way, just quarantine them. Put them away. We are all good at quarantine now, so just quarantine any of those negative thoughts. Lift the heels, bend the knees, make your way to the top of your mat. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Take an inhale here. Exhale, hands down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Bend the knees, plant the hands, high plank. Roll forward. Any version of chaturanga, so knees down, but I'm just gonna move into regular chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. If you're an upward facing dog, you can sway your hips side to side, shoulders side to side, and curl the toes under, downward facing dog. Breathing here, three. Make the breath even.
Never meant to do those things to you.
Next inhale, lift the heels, bend the knees, make your way to the top of your mat. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, reach all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Take a deep breath in here. Exhale, down. Nice, everybody. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Bend the knees. Step back, high plank. Remember the modifications. Roll forward. Chaturanga. Cobra, upward facing dog. Exhale, back. Downward facing dog. One more sun A, lift the heels, bend the knees, make your way to the top of your mat. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach all the way up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale here. Exhale, hands come down. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen. Bend your knees, plant the hands, step or jump back. Chaturanga. Cobra, upward facing dog. Exhale, back. Downward facing dog. And breathe. Lift your heels, bend your knees, make your way to the top of your mat. Lengthen the spine. Exhale, fold forward. Fingertips down, bend the knees. Chair pose, feet, big toes touch. They can be a little bit apart also, your feet. Sit your hips back. Reach up, arms alongside your ears. Cactus arms or hands at your heart center. And breathe. Hold. Can you stay? Three, two, one. Hands to heart center. Take a deep breath in, lengthening. Turn the body to the right. Left elbow comes outside the right knee. Check that the right knee doesn't move back. Make a fist with your right hand and twist. Those of you who like to spread your wings here, spread your wings. Coming back to heart center. One breath in here. I know it's getting tiring for the legs. Focus on the toes. Bring the hands to your heart center. Turn the body to the left. Take a twist. Bring the right elbow above the left knee. Use your fist and twist. The lengthening, the inhale is the lengthening breath. The exhale is the twisting breath. Coming back to heart center. Reach the arms up and forward fold. Nice. Inhale, lengthen. Toe heel your feet apart. Grab on either to your big toes with your peace fingers or slide your hands underneath your feet. Inhale, lengthen the spine. This is gorilla pose. And bend the knees, bend the elbows, deep forward fold. If your toes are reaching your wrists, it's a good time to massage those wrists. Inhale, lengthen. Release your hands. Toe heel your feet apart. Toes out, heels in. Coming into goddess squat. Elbows inside the thighs. You can be here. This is goddess squat. This is goddess squat. This is goddess squat. Keep the belly pulling in and up. Those of you who have Bakasana in your practice, I invite you to take a crow pose. Bakasana. Hands come down. Otherwise, stay in your goddess squat. Feet together, and then bend the knees. Bring them into the armpits or outside of the arms. Lift one leg, maybe lift the second. And hold. Keep holding. I'm just coming back into goddess for those of you in goddess squat. Breathe. Those of you in Bakasana, come on out. Meet us in goddess. Bring the hands down, toe heel the feet together. Inhale, lengthen. Bend the knees. Step back, either to downward dog or take a vinyasa. From now on, all vinyasas are optional. They're just an invitation if it's something your body needs. Right leg lifts. Bring the knee into the chest. Little bit of core here. Inhale, right leg lifts. Exhale, right knee, right arm. Inhale, back up. Exhale, twist it towards the left elbow. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, bring the knee into the chest. Step the right foot between the hands. If you need to, drop the left knee. Coming into a warrior one. Reach the arms up. So, left foot at an angle. Right knee over right ankle. Reach up. Airplane the arms back. Inhale, reach up. And airplane the arms back. Interlace the fingers. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Stay here, or humble warrior. Right shoulder on the right thigh, or inside the right thigh. Let the arms lift, head hangs heavy. You're breathing. Your back leg is strong. Your right leg is strong. You are strong. Inhale, reach back up. Bring the hands to heart center. Right hand on the right knee. Left hand comes down. Lift to the ball of the back foot. Twist. Staying here or coming into side plank. Spin the left heel to the left. Either walk your foot halfway down or come into full side plank. You can have your left knee down also. Hold here. Bring your right arm over your right ear if it's okay. For those of you who just want a little more core, bring elbow to knee and reach. Two more. Inhale. And three. Excellent, guys. All good choices. Bring the right hand down. And roll forward. You can take your downward dog or vinyasa, upward facing dog. Exhale back. Okay, other side, so you know where we're going. Left leg lifts. Exhale, knee comes into the chest, round the back. You're stronger than you think. Exceed yourself to find your exceeding self. Left knee to the left arm. Inhale, reach up. This can all be done with the right knee down. Twist it. Inhale. Left leg lifts. Bring the knee into the chest. Look between the hands. You can drop the right knee to step the left foot forward. Set up. Warrior one. Left knee forward. Reach up. Maybe bend the elbows this time. Back bend. Inhale, reach up. Airplane the arms back. Hover. Inhale, reach up. And airplane. And reach up. And airplane the arms. Hover. Interlace your fingers. Squeeze the shoulder blades together. Stay here, or humble warrior. Left shoulder on left thigh or inside. Hang heavy. Let everything just drop. Let it go. Whatever it is for you. Inhale, reach back up. Hands to heart center. Left hand comes to the left knee. Right hand comes down. I'm gonna stay in this view so you can see the view from the back. Twist, left arm up. For those of you who wanna stay here, stay. Or right foot, right heel spins to the right. Walk the left foot. Stay in a modified side plank or side plank. Reach the left arm over the left ear if you want. Three crunches. Left knee to the left elbow. Reach. And two. Exhale. Inhale. And three. Reach. Nice. For those of you who are just vinyasa junkies, go for it. Otherwise, downward facing dog. And exhale back. And breathe. Breathe. Child's pose is always available. This is child's pose. Always available. Lift your heels, bend your knees, make your way to the top of your mat. Come into a flat back. Exhale, fold. Fingertips down, chair pose. Familiar already, right? Moving into eagle. Shift the weight to the left. Lift the right foot. Wrap the right foot over. You can even have the right toe down for balance. Take the arms out. Right arm goes under. Lift the elbows up. Move the forearms away from the face. Keep the belly pulled in towards the spine, up towards the ribs. Sink a little lower because you can. Slowly unravel the leg. If you have to lower it down in between, you can. We're coming into airplane with eagle arms. Flex the foot, the right foot. You can have a soft bend in the left foot if you need. Unravel the arms. Airplane pose, palms face down. The houses caught fire. Bring the knee in, hands to heart center. If you need to re-get your balance, just lower the right foot. Right knee lifts. So you're here, left hand on your left hip, can stay here. Those of you who like to grab the big toe, grab the toe, and we're extending. If you want, if you have the hamstring flexibility. Otherwise, you are here. Then begin to open up. If you're holding your knee, open up also, opening up the hip to the right. Breathe. Left arm can come out to the side if you want. I have to lift mine up. I have a Van Gogh picture behind me. Bring the right knee or the right foot back. and settle into tree pose. Right foot on the left thigh, left shin, or down, and ground down here. Find the equanimity here. Bring the knee into the chest. An option to take a dancer's pose here. Right knee next to the left, left arm comes out. Begin to bring the torso forward and the right knee and thigh lift, pushing the foot against the hand. Come back down, lower down, shake it out. I'll change sides. One side to go for this sequence. All started with a chair. Come into a forward fold. Fingertips down, bend the knees. Chair pose. Begin to shift the weight to the right foot. Left leg wraps. Left arm comes under. Lift the elbows, move the forearms away. And breathing, feeling the stretch in the upper back. Nice stretch. Look at the ability for the body to make adjustments. That is us. We know how to make adjustments. We are capable. Begin to unravel the left leg. You can keep a soft bend in your right leg. Coming into airplane with eagle arms. And then unravel the arms. Airplane pose. Reach up. Bring the left knee up. If you need to reposition, just let the left knee come down for a break. Otherwise, knees up. Hug the knee in. Right hand on your right hip. You either are holding onto the knee, holding here. Those of you who like to take a hold of the big toe, take a hold of the big toe. You can stay here or stretch the hamstring out. You can have your hand on your hip or reach the right arm up. Breathing, standing tall. And then open up to the left. Keep a fixed gaze on one point. And then come back to center. You're here. And settle in tree. Turn around again. So you're tree with the left foot lifted. Left big toe could be down. It could be on your shin. Could be on your thigh, and you could be holding onto a wall if you want. Otherwise, play around with hand postures. Arms could be up, hands could be behind you. Find your breath. Nice. If you do not want to do dancer's pose, stay in tree or just release. Bring the knee in and grab your left foot with your left hand, the inside. Reach the right arm forward and begin to come forward, lifting the left knee and the left thigh as the torso comes down. Pushing the foot against the hand, hand against the foot. And gently release. If you're in tree, release. Shake it out. Awesome. Here we go. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Vinyasa or downward facing dog, your choice. I'm a vinyasa junkie, so I'm just gonna take my vinyasa. Upward dog. Exhale, back. Right leg lifts, inhale. Bend the knee, open up. Stay here or flip your dog. Right foot comes behind. And then if you have flipped, look back down. Bring the right hand down. Pivot your left heel to the right side of the room, shooting the right leg out for fallen triangle or fallen angel. You pick the term, whatever speaks to you.
We can burn bright.
Bring the left hand back down. Right leg is back up. Maybe we're meeting some of you there. Bring the knee into the chest. Step the right foot. Set up for crescent lunge. And reach up. Taking an open arm twist here. Left arm comes forward. Right arm comes behind you. You can look behind you. Both legs strong. Right hand comes to the outside of the left thigh. Reach the left arm up. Nice work, guys. Reach both arms up. We're going to open up into a warrior two. I'm just going to switch my view. So right foot forward. Right knee over right ankle, right heel. Aiming towards the left arch of the left heel. And breathe. Reach forward. Flip the palm, reverse. Come into a side angle with your right forearm on your right thigh. And reverse. And come into your right forearm over your right thigh. Side angle pose, one more. Reverse. You guys are strong. Both legs strong. Body flexible. Come into your warrior two. Straighten the right leg. Toe heel your left foot in. Turn the toes at an angle. Left hand on your hip. Moving into triangle pose. Reach. 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 If you have a block, grab your block or your can of corn or your shin. Shin's a great prop. And come into triangle pose. I almost moved into the next pose, confusing you all. But you know where we're going from here. If you want, reach your right arm forward to add some core. And if you want, bring the left arm over the left ear and hold here your triangle, or your triangle is still here. And then come back up. Bend the right knee. Look to the upper right corner of your mat. Take your block, can of corn, or your hands to the upper right corner. I look like I'm gonna bump into my bed, right? Balancing half moon. Flex the left foot. Those of you who like to bind it up for Shavasana, grab the inside of the foot. You have the bind, let it go, because we're coming into a reverse balancing half moon. So the left hand goes down. It can go on the block or on the floor. You point the toes, right arm lifts, turning the chest to the right. Nice, slowly lower the left foot back down. Right foot is still forward, left foot back. Hop the left foot in a little bit. Coming into a twisted triangle. Left arm lifts up high. Reach forward. Lengthen. And then lower the left hand to the pinky toe edge of the right foot or your shin, turning the body to the right. Reach the right arm up. If you want, you can take a half bind here, or you can just keep the right arm up. Bring the hand back to your hip, lift up halfway, maybe grab opposite elbows or stay with your hands on your hips, staying with a flat back or pyramid pose where you begin to fold forward over two straight legs. Pull the right hip back a little bit, feel the stretch in the butt and the right hamstring. Inhale, come back up. Turn the right toes to be parallel with the left. See how we're doing on time. Okay, Prasarita. Hands to the hips. Inhale, arch. And fold forward. You can use a block here. Flat back. If you're gonna go into an inversion to a headstand and you know how to do it, go for it. You would have to probably hop your legs back a little bit. Your head has to reach the ground. Your hands come in line with your feet and your head makes a triangle with the two hands. So the head comes down, hug the elbows in, lift the legs. And hold. But I'm gonna come out. Hold for two more breaths if you're up. And then begin to spread your legs if you're up and slowly lower them down. Everybody into a flat back, Prasarita. Bend the right knee, walk your hands to the upper right corner of your mat, lengthening the body. And walk them to the left, bend the left knee, reach to the left corner of the mat. And come back to center. Turn to face the left foot. Vinyasa or downward facing dog. One side to go. And then we're on the floor. Ready, set, practice with me. Left leg lifts. Bend the knee, open up the hip. Stay or flip out. Don't flip out on me. Just flip the dog. If you have flipped your dog, look down, bring the left hand down, spin your right heel to the left, shoot the left leg out for fallen triangle or fallen angel. Bring the right hand down. If you're in fallen angel, left leg comes back up where some of you might be. Bring the knee into the chest, step into crescent lunge, reach up, left knee's forward, strong right leg back. Open arm twist, right arm comes forward, left arm comes behind you. Look over the left arm, left shoulder if it feels okay. Lower the left hand to the outside of the right thigh, reach the right arm forward. Come back up, crescent lunge. Open up into your warrior two. Long stance here. Left heel towards the right arch or right heel. Reach the left arm forward. Flip the arm. Reverse the warrior. Side angle pose. Left forearm on left thigh. Switch to reverse warrior. Left forearm on left thigh. Reverse the warrior. One more time. Left forearm, left thigh, and come back up. Straighten the left leg. Triangle pose. I'm not gonna do it with the block this time. I'm gonna use the prop of my own shin. Reach, reach, reach. Lower the left hand down, and right arm comes up. For those of you who wanted to add that extra core, reach the right arm over the right ear. And then maybe lift the left arm. Strong legs, strong belly. Come back up. Bend the left knee. Toe heel your right foot in, coming into balancing half moon at the upper left corner of your mat. Flex the foot, opening up the chest to the right. Those of you who like a bind, reach for the inside of the foot. Opening up the chest. Awesome work, guys. Almost there. Release if you have the bind. Switching to a twisted crescent lunge. The hips square. The right toes point. Left arm lifts. Turning the chest to the left. And then lower the left hand, bend the knee, lower the right foot, coming up to stand. Hands on your hips, shorter stance, twisted triangle, reach the right arm up, lengthen, come forward, shin, block, bring the hand on the outside of, right hand on the outside of the left foot, and twist, Those of you who took a half bind, go for it. Coming back to midline, flat back. Reverse namaste or opposite elbow, stay in a flat back here or fold forward for pyramid. Breathing. You still breathing? Well, I think I can hear you guys breathing. Wow, that's powerful. Inhale, lengthen. Come on up. Turn the left toes to be parallel with the right. One more prasarita. This time, interlace your fingers behind your back. Squeeze the shoulder blades together and fold forward. Release your hands, come to a flat back. Reach the fingers forward, lengthen. And then begin to walk the hands in and reach the hands through behind you. And bend one knee, right knee, and left knee to the beat. Bend, 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 bend. Both knees bend. And straighten both. Bend. And straighten. And bend. And straighten one more time. Bend. Straighten. Bring the hands forward. Walk your hands to the left. And step the left foot back, push back into downward dog, bend your knees, cross your ankles behind you, come into a boat pose. Okay, boat pose, feet, toes up, heels down, this can be your boat pose. You can hold on to the backs of the legs, keep your feet here, or at a 90 degree angle, or straighten your legs. And at any point you can let go. I like my knees bent. And breathe. Four low boats to high boats, just four. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale two. Exhale. Inhale three. Exhale. Inhale four. Exhale. Hug the knees into the chest. Beautiful. Place your feet down. Come on to your backs. Coming into a bridge pose. You can do a supported bridge. If you have a block, or I wouldn't put a can underneath you, some books, a bolster, or if you don't have anything, that's okay. You plant your feet down. Make sure you can reach your heels with your middle fingers. Lift the hips, interlace your fingers behind you. Squeeze the shoulder blades together, squeeze. Lift the hips and hold, hold, breathing. You can also be supporting your sacrum with your hands. Two more breaths and lower down. Gonna be doing that again with the option for full wheel. So windshield wiper your feet. Okay, make sure your middle fingers can reach your heels. Pigeon toe your feet a little bit. Either come up into your bridge, or if you have wheel in your practice, take your hands beside your ears. Lift to the crown of the head, and inhale, reach up for five, four, three, two, one. Lower down. Windshield wiper the feet. We have one more of those. Now, usually in class, when I can see all of you, this is where some of you, like, I don't know, begin to, like, I don't know, don't love this pose. Just do it. I'm not looking at the screen, so I don't even know who's doing it, but come on. Really, back bends are energizing. We have a day ahead of us. Okay, one last time. Bridge your wheel. Hands beside your ears. Lift to the crown of your head if you're doing wheel and push up. Option to bring your right knee into your chest. Lift the left leg up. I mean, the right leg up. That would be, wow, that would be enlightenment. Bend the knee. lower the right foot, and then bring the left knee in and lift the left leg up. I hope you're all still breathing. And lower, deep breath in, and everybody lower down. Supta Baddha Konasana, left hand on your heart center, right hand on your belly center. Feel the breath, the hard work is behind you. Stay there, check how I'm doing with time. Okay. Feel the breath, feel amazed. Know that your body is working for you. Your breath is working for you. We are able to quiet the mind. We are able to find our exceeding self. Okay, two options for hip opener. If you're just so happy to finally be on your back, stay on your back. Take your right ankle over your left thigh. Interlace your fingers behind your left thigh. Bring the left foot into a 90 degree angle. Use your right elbow, open up. Those of you who are happy to sit up, I will instruct double pigeon. So you bring your left foot parallel with the mat. Cross your right ankle over the left knee. Beginning to lose my right left. And stay here, feel the opening in the hip. Make sure this is okay on your knee if you're doing this option. And if it feels okay for you, you come forward here. Those of you on your back, stay. We're working the right side. Just melt into it. Wherever you are, those of you who decided on your own to take half pigeon on your belly, I salute you also. That's a great pose. Stay. Two more breaths, wherever you are, in whichever right hip opener you're in. And switch sides. So if you're on your back, you will take your left foot over the right ankle and do the same thing. If you are in seated pigeon, your right foot becomes, the shin becomes parallel, and the left ankle over the right knee. And we're not equal on both sides. If one side, let's say that you're doing double pigeon and this side just doesn't feel good for the knee, do the either the version on your belly or do it on your back. Inhale, lengthen, and maybe come forward. So those of you who, while we're holding this, I'll just make a plug for things you're looking to do. So this song, Stand Up, which I love, if you're in my classes, I lots of times talk about the music. This is from a movie called Harriet Tubman, who was considered the Moses of the slaves. And it's an excellent movie, excellent. So I know people are looking for things to watch. It's a good family movie, actually. So I recommend it. It's called Harriet. Meanwhile, enjoy the song. I haven't forgotten that we're opening up our left hip. If you're thinking, oh my God, what is she thinking? It's 10:08, but we did start 2 minutes or 3 minutes late. So just grant me that. Stay, a few more breaths. Oh, I love all the poses you guys are taking. Awesome. Some of you don't have your camera on, but that's okay. I can feel you're doing great poses. I know. And I feel all your support. All right, release that. come into Baddha Konasana. You can do it seated. I need everybody seated, actually, because we're going to take a seated forward fold. So come up to a seat if you were on your back. Baddha Konasana, soles of the feet together, and just rock side to side. You can hold on to the big toes. You can come into a forward fold. You can bring your knees in, and you can take one more time hold of your toes, and if you want, bring them up and open them wide. Again, keeping length in the spine, your choice. Extend your legs straight. Coming into a Dandasana, hands beside your hips, feeling lengthened, loose. And inhale, reach forward. Coming into a Paschimottanasana, you can have your knees bent. You can use a strap. Seated forward fold. Be mindful of your back. If you have any back issues, the knees stay bent. And take any hold you like. If you like to grab a wrist around the feet, if you like to grab the big toes. And slowly come up. Those of you who are aching for an inversion, now's the time to do it. Another inversion. Forearm balance, handstand, shoulder stand. The rest of us, reverse tabletop, place your feet down. Inhale, the hips up, opening up the shoulders, keeping the belly engaged, feeling the strength of the legs as if there's a block between them. Maybe let your head drop back. And slowly lower it back down. Those of you still in your inversion, begin to think about coming down and taking a child's pose. And we will come meet on our backs. Place your feet down. Lift your hips up. Move them to the right. Extend the left foot straight. Take the right arm out. Shoulder level. Hug the right knee in. Take your left hand on the outside of the right knee. And pull it over, keeping your chest open, the shoulder on the ground. Should feel great. Soften the breath. Come back into center, hug the knee in. Maybe hug the knee up, the leg up. And then place the right foot down, move the hips to the left, extend the right foot straight, take the left arm out, right hand on the outside of the left knee, and twist to the other side. Just let your feelings roll long by. Don't wear fear. Jordan, can you change it to the next song? Okay, hug the left knee in, maybe hug the leg. Come into a quick, place your feet down, realign yourself, center. Come into a happy baby pose, grabbing onto the outsides of the soles of the feet or the insides, whether you like inside shoulder rotation or outside or external shoulder rotation. And rock side to side, pressing down so that you get your sacrum and the lower back down on the mat and lengthen. Rock. You have done it. You are here. You have practiced. You are safe and privileged and have so much to be grateful for. Slowly lower your feet down. Let them open wide. Let the feet open naturally. If anything's in your way, just move it out. Take your hands alongside your body again. Use up space. Let the fingers curl, palms face up. Relax your forehead, your eyebrows, your jaw. Check if you're holding on anywhere. Release the legs. Take a deep breath in. Close the eyes. And exhale through the mouth. Another deep breath in. Exhale out through the mouth. And don't escape. Do not run away from Shavasana. Most important pose of the practice. And stay. Stay. Okay, if you want to continue staying in Shavasana, do so, because I know it's a really short Shavasana. For the rest of you, begin to move your fingers and toes, bring your awareness back to your breath, reach your arms overhead, point your toes, roll the ankles, feel the length and expansion that's been created and flexibility. Hug your knees into your chest, make yourself into a round ball. And with your eyes closed, gently roll to your right to a fetal position. Again, if this is where you want to stay, just stay. Great position also. And for the rest of you, push yourself up to a seated position, just like we started. A comfortable seat, sitting bones grounded down, shoulders relaxed, neck loose. You are here. You are so capable of adjusting. We are capable of making change. We are all here together. Bring your hands into your heart center. Take a deep breath in. And as we exhale out, together we say namaste. Thank you guys for practicing with me. Thank you to the Thrive community. Thank you to Jordan Polavoy. There's many classes on the schedule today for you, your family. So take a look at the schedule. Send a chat if you want to unmute your Zoom and say hi to me. That would be great. If you have any feedback, let me know. Wishing you all a Shabbat Shalom, a happy Thursday.